Assalamualaikum student, today we will do unit number 12, which is a poem. The title of the poem is The Old Woman. Today we will do reading plus glossary of the text or glossary of the poem, class 9, subject English. Now coming to unit number 10, which is the poem The Old Woman, and it is written by Joseph Campbell. I will share some information about the poet with you. The poet Joseph Campbell was born in 1906 in White Plains, New York. He won name and fame as a writer, poet, and athlete. So he was famous as a writer, as a poet, and as athlete. Athlete means sport person. His first published work was Where the Two Came to Their Father. The poem The Old Woman has been taken from his collections of poems. He described the old age of a woman. The beauty of a woman vanishes and she looks like a white candle in her old age. Now coming to poem. As a white candle in a holy place, so is the beauty of an aged face. This is stanza number one. In stanza number one, the poet has described the beauty of an old woman by comparing his with candle placed in a holy place. As a white candle in a holy place. As a white candle usually placed in a holy place. Holy place, Muqaddas Makam. As Christians used to lit a candle in a church, church is a holy place for them. So he is comparing the beauty of old women with that white candle which they usually lit in the churches in their holy place. So is the beauty of an aged face. So the beauty of an aged face means bure chehre ki khubsurti. So the beauty of an aged woman is just like the white candle which Christians used to lit in their holy place in the church. In this stanza, the poet beautifully used the simile and he symbolizes the beauty of an aged woman with the candle which is, with the white candle which is in the holy place. एक सफ़ेद मोमबत्ती की तरह जो कि एक मुकद्दस मकाम पर होती है, इसी तरह एक उम्र रसीदा चेहरे की खूबसूरती होती है. नाउ कमिंग टू स्टैंजा नंबर टू. एज द स्पेंट रेडियंस ऑफ द विंटर सन, सो इज अ वुमन विद हर ट्रेवल डन. एज द स्पेंट रेडियंस, स्पेंट मीन्स अ थिंग विच हैज़ become lighter with its overuse. As the spent, madham, radiance means brightness, roshni, of the winter sun. As the spent radiance of the winter sun, jis tarha, spent means a thing which is overused, jiska bahut zyada istemal ke baad uski roshni kam pad gayi ho, uski roshni madham pad gayi ho. Jis tarha istemal shuda roshni of the winter sun, जिस तरह सर्दियों में सूरज की रोशनी मध्यम होती है, so is a woman with her travail done. Travail means laborious job, hard work of her life. इसी तरह एक औरत जिसने सख्त मेहनत की होती है. In this stanza, the poet uses simile for comparing the spent radiance of the winter sun with the old woman. That she becomes weak, but she is still rich in her life experiences, with her travail done, with her laborious job done. So in stanza number two, the poet want to say that by facing so many unpleasant experiences and hardships in her life, the old woman become weak, and he compare the weak woman with the spent radiance of the winter sun. Now coming to stanza number three. her brood gone from her. Her brood, brood means children, gone from her. And her thoughts are as still as the waters under a ruined mill. हर ब्रूड हर चिल्ड्रन गॉन फ्रॉम हर चले गए हैं उसके बच्चे उसको छोड़कर चले गए हैं एंड हर थॉट्स एज स्टिल एज द वाटर्स और उसके ख्यालात ऐसे स्टिल स्टिल मीन्स साकिन हैं बे हरकत हैं एज द वाटर्स जैसे कि पानी अंडर अ रुअन मिल रुअन मिल रुअन मिल्स तबाहशुदा मिल चक्की और वर्किंग प्लेस उसके ख्यालात ऐसे हैं जैसे तबाहशुदा चक्की में पानी खड़ा होता है. सो इन दिस स्टेंजा द पोएट वांट टू से दैट आफ्टर व्हेन शी वाज लेफ्ट बाय हर चिल्ड्रन हर थॉट्स आर एज स्टिल उसके ख्यालात ऐसे साकिन हैं. देयर इज़ नो लाइफ देयर इज़ नो चार्म इन हर लाइफ आफ्टर अ लेबरस जॉब हैज़ बीन डन and her life is just as water is still water is just like stagnant water beharkat aisa uske khayalat aise hain jaise beharkat pani jo ke pani bhi still hai under the ruined mill ek aisi chakki ek aise kaam karne wali jagah jo ke tabah ho chuki hai jahan par koi kaam nahi hota ab. So in short, you can say all the activities, all the liveliness, all the charm of the life of old woman has gone when her brood gone from her. So what is the main idea of writing the old woman? It is the main idea for writing the old woman is that you should respect your elders. You have to serve them in their old age. In this poem, the poet want to say that the old woman has gone through the hardships of life and still her beauty is just like the white candle in the holy place. But after when their broods gone from her, so her thoughts were still just as a water in the ruined mill. Now coming to glossary. Glossary is radiance. Radiance means roshni, a special bright quality that shows in somebody's face, for example because they are very happy or healthy. Travail means mushakkat, an unpleasant experience or situation that involves a lot of hard work, difficulties and suffering. Brood, a person's child or children. Ruined. Ruined means tabah, destroyed or severely damaged so that only parts remain. Your activity is you have to learn glossary of unit number 12. Thank you.